हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई टेक अप ए न्यू टॉपिक एंड द नेम ऑफ द टॉपिक इज द वर्ल्ड हेल्थ डे, ए न्यू चैलेंज टू इंडिया। माय लेसन प्लान इंक्लूड्स व्हाई इज इट इन द न्यूज, इंडिया एंड क्लाइमेट चेंज एक्शन प्रोग्राम बाय इंडिया एंड हेल्थ फॉर ऑल कंक्लूजन। So under these points I will cover today's topic, and that is the World Health Day, a new challenge for India. So now, why is it in the news? Friends, as you know that the World Health Day is celebrated every year on 7th April. Today is 7th April, and that's why I have taken up this topic. And now it is the program being launched by World Health Organization. Its headquarter is at Geneva in Switzerland. And now this program is for the awareness among people about the health related issues. Now the theme of this year's Health Day, World Health Day, is Our Planet, Our Health. Our Planet, Our Health. Every year WHO announces a new slogan on World Health Day, and so this year in 2022 the slogan is Our Planet, Our Health. And so friend, I will stick to planet, how to achieve sustainable development goal, and what are our health issues in India, what are the strong point, weak points in matter relating to health sector in our country. So I will focus on these two points. Now, to address the issue of pollution growing on the planet, diseases like cancer, diarrhea, asthma, heart related diseases, these are the important health issues that has to be addressed by each and every country. And so or this organization WHO aims to focus global attention on the urgent action needed to keep humans and the planet healthy. So friends, the objective of WHO is to keep our planet, our health free from disease and pollution. These are the two mottos that has been ascribed by World Health Organization this year. So I will stick to these points. Friends, as you know that world warming has become an important issue. It has increased the world temperature by 1.5 degrees Celsius, and this increase in temperature, worldwide temperature, has disastrous impact upon the ecosystem, the world ecosystem, upon glaciers, upon the sea level of water, upon coastal areas, upon the health of people, because increase in temperature always cause several diseases among different state of society. And so This is an important issue that world is facing today. Our planet is warming very much. We have to control it. We have to reduce the emission of carbon. And similarly, there are health hazards, particularly in developing countries like India. So now second point is India and climate change. So now I will stick to as to how India tried its level best to control emission of carbon, how it contributed towards a pollution-free environment to achieve sustainable development goals. So now India realizes and is very much sensitive to the issue of climate change. National Action Plan for Climate Change was launched in 2008, and the objective of the national plan was adaptation and mitigation. Adaptation and mitigation through focused national missions. There are two objectives that form the part of National Plan for Climate Change, and that action plan was adaptation and mitigation. So now there are eight missions, national missions, that has been launched by Government of India to contain warming of globe, global warming, or to achieve sustainable development goals. Now these national missions are: number one, to perform, achieve and trade, in short PAT scheme, is for enhanced energy efficiency for the reduction of energy consumption. And now 100 designated customers were notified in April 2019. The total energy consumption of these DCs comes out to be 55.244 million tons of oil equivalent. Oil equivalent, MT, million ton of oil equivalent, MTOE in short. What is the meaning of million ton oil equivalent? It means that how much 1 liter of oil produces energy. This is called oil equivalent of energy, and million ton oil equivalent energy, this is the short form of MTOE. And it is expected to get energy savings of 0.5130 MTOE by 2020, about 20 MTOE, million ton oil equivalent of energy saving estimated under this scheme. Friends, as you know that this is the chart, pie chart, that will show you what are the components of energy. And see, coal constitute 44.3%, biomass and waste 21.2%, petroleum, oil, liquids 25.3%, natural gas 5.8%, nuclear energy 1.1%, hydroelectric 1.4%, and other renewable source of energy 0.8%. Now this is the component as to how the energy is produced in India. And you will see that fossil fuel constitute 80% of the electricity generation in India. What is the need of our? Because you know that fossil fuel creates or emits large scale carbon, and which is the important source of global warming. And that's why reduction or less dependence upon fossil fuels एंड मोर इम्फेसिस अपॉन नॉन कन्वेंशनल सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी इज द नीड ऑफ पावर एंड दैट्स व्हाई गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इज नाउ फोकसिंग मोर एंड मोर अपॉन जनरेशन ऑफ सोलर एनर्जी. नाउ नेशनल सोलर मिशन अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस मिशन इट एम्स टू इंक्रीज द शेयर ऑफ सोलर एनर्जी इन द टोटल एनर्जी मिक्स. टारगेट हैज बीन सेट एट 100 गीगावाट. फ्रेंड्स एज यू नो दैट 1 गीगावाट इज इक्वल टू 1 मिलियन किलोवाट. 1 मिलियन किलोवाट और 1000 मेगावाट. सो द टारगेट बाय गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इज टू प्रोड्यूस 100 गीगावाट जनरेशन बाय ऑफ सोलर पावर एनर्जी एट द कॉस्ट ऑफ 6 लाख करोड़ रुपीज बाय नवंबर 2019 एंड 32.5 गीगावाट सोलर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी जनरेशन हैज बीन कंप्लीटेड. नाउ गवर्नमेंट हैज टू कंप्लीट 67.5 गीगावाट इन नियर फ्यूचर. सो द मोर फोकस इज अपॉन रिन्यूएबल सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी. फ्रेंड्स एज यू नो दैट सोलर एनर्जी इज एन इनएग्जॉस्टिबल सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी. एट द प्रेजेंट मोमेंट अकॉर्डिंग टू पाई चार्ट व्हाट वी सी दैट अदर रिन्यूएबल सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी लाइक विंड पावर लाइक सोलर एनर्जी दीज पावर constitute not more than 0.8% of the total energy production in India. So what is required? It is required that India should increase the generation of solar energy and that's why government of India charted its course to augment the production of solar energy and now by 2019 it has produced 32.5 gigawatts of solar energy and this is a big achievement. Again national water mission, what is this? It aims at to install mandatory rainwater harvesting, number one, rooftop rain harvesting in 1071 assessment units. Moreover, it requires mapping of the different areas and then to classify the country into different zones as far as availability of water is concerned. So where there is water scarce area, the need of the hour is to conserve water by way of rainwater harvesting, rooftop rainwater harvesting. And now this has kept on momentum in our country, particularly in Deccan and South India. Now, National Mission for Green India aims at reduction of emission of carbon dioxide. Action taken under this plan are afforestation activities and promoting alternate energy at household level. Alternate source of energy like solar energy, like other form of energy. So these are the two-pronged approach to solve the problem of carbon emission. The aim is to reduce the quantum of carbon emission and so less dependency upon fossil fuel energy. Now and For this, Government of India launched a vigorous program for forestation. And friends, as you know that earlier, 10 years back, there were only 22% area that was covered under forest. And now, what you see, that now it has increased to 24.8% of the total geographical area of India. So there is an increase in the area of forestation, and that is a good sign, that is a good development to reduce carbon emission. Now, National Mission on Sustainable Habitat, it consists of mandatory energy conservation for commercial buildings having load of 100 kilowatt or above, mass rapid transit system, solid waste management, water and sanitation, storm water drainage, urban planning, energy efficiency, urban transport. These are the mechanisms by which National Mission for Sustainable Habits can be obtained. Now, National Mission for Sustainable Agriculture. Friends, you know that ours is an agriculture country. In spite of the fact that the contribution of agriculture in our total GDP is now getting less and less, still 47.5% people are living upon agriculture. So there is a need to have a sustainable agriculture in India. And that's why Government of India is planning to double the income of farmers by 2024. Now, it aims at enhancing food security in our country and protection of resources. Key target includes 3.5 lakh hectare under organic farming, 3.70 lakh hectare under minor irrigation, 7 lakh hectare under rice intensification, because you know that now the eastern India comprising Bihar, West Bengal and coastal areas of Orissa and Brahmaputra Valley, these areas have been chalked out for the cultivation of rice. Why? Because the production and productivity in the green revolution belt like the Western UP, Punjab and Haryana, now they are declining, and that's why in order to support or to increase the food production in our country so that we should not face food shortage, what we are witnessing now in Sri Lanka. So Government of India has now expanded the area of green revolution, particularly of rice in eastern India like West Bengal, Bihar, Brahmaputra Valley and the coastal area of Orissa, where there is a ample availability of water. And now 3.41 lakh hectare under diversification of less water consuming crops, 3.09 lakh hectare under plantation in arable land. So these are the important areas where sustainable agriculture focuses upon, so that our agriculture should be robust, should be self-reliant, should be resilient. And that's why these are the area where the government focuses to increase the diversification, to increase the rice cultivation, to more plantation in these areas. And key areas have been to keep certain, 3.5 lakh hectare under organic farming. And friends, you know, this organic farming must not be increased. And we have seen in Sri Lanka how Sri Lanka adopted organic farming in 2020-21. It banned chemical fertilizers and urea, with the result that its yield came down by 50%, leading to food shortages in Sri Lanka. And that's why Sri Lanka now imported 2 lakh ton from India, 1 lakh ton from Pakistan, 1 lakh ton from Myanmar, and 2,000 ton from China. Rice. So, the production and productivity in rice cultivation very much came down. And that's why Sri Lanka had to import rice from India, Myanmar, and China. So, we must not fully rely upon organic farming. But certain area can be chalked out for organic farming. Now, National Mission for Sustaining Himalayan Ecosystem. Now, friends, you know that our northern belt is covered by Himalayas. Now, Jammu, Kashmir, Uttarakhand, Ladakh, Himachal Pradesh, and Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh, all these areas are under Himalayan ecosystem. And so you see that if we want sustainable development goal, we will have to maintain a proper Himalayan ecosystem in our country, because Himalayas are the perennial source of water for us. We can't conceive to sustain ourselves without Himalayas. So there should not be any disturbance in the ecosystem in Himalayan region. And that's why government wants and government set up Center of Glaciology, State Climate Change Center in the Himalaya State, 40 training programs, formation of inter-university consortium. Now, National Mission on Strategic Knowledge on Climate Change. The key achievement includes setting up 11 centers of excellence, 7 human capacity building and national knowledge network program in the areas of climate change science. Now, climate change action program. Major action under the scheme are that has been adopted by Government of India, and these are energy audit studies. And friends, you know that this energy audit study revealed that 40% energy can be conserved. The wastage of 40% of energy in our country can be saved or conserved by proper auditing of energy sector. Now, a scheme like Ujjala, by which LED bulbs are distributed and conventional street lights are being replaced by LED, are being implemented. Again, electric and hybrid vehicles are being manufactured in our country in order to reduce the emission of carbon. Again, National Biofuel Policy 2018 target 20% blending of ethanol in petrol and 5% blending of biodiesel in diesel by 2030. And friends, as you know that we are 80% dependent upon foreign countries for petroleum products. Whenever there is an international upheavals, changes, the direct impact is upon India. Now you see that within the span of 12 days, government has to increase the prices of petroleum products by 10 rupees. So this has become necessary on account of the failure of chain, supply of chain caused by Russia-Ukrainian war, which is going on for more than 1 month. So the failure in the supply chain created और रेज द प्राइसेज ऑफ पेट्रोलियम प्रोडक्ट्स इन आवर कंट्री बिकॉज वी आर 80% डिपेंडेंट अपॉन फॉरेन कंट्रीज फॉर पेट्रोलियम प्रोडक्ट्स एंड दिस इज आवर माइनस पॉइंट. सो यू सी दैट्स वाई गवर्नमेंट वॉन्ट्स टू इंक्रीज और टू फिक्स द टारगेट ऑफ 20% ब्लेंडिंग इथनॉल इन पेट्रोल एंड 5% इन बायो 5% बायोडीजल इन डीजल बाय 2030 इन ऑर्डर टू ऑफ रिड्यूस द हैवी कॉस्ट ऑफ इम्पोर्ट ऑफ ऑयल प्रोडक्ट्स इन आवर इकोनॉमी. नाउ परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ इंडिया फॉर सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल्स. What are the important steps that government of India has taken for the last 10 to 20 years? And now I am going to describe one by one. Number one, you see that the three pillars of development are social, economic and environmental. And if we want to develop our economy, we will have to take into account these three factors. Number one, economic, social and environmental issues. Now India reduced the emission intensity of GDP by 21% during 2005 to 2014. This is a big achievement. Now 175 gigawatt target for renewable source of energy by 2020 will play a positive role in this direction. Again, forest and tree covers now have increased, and I have already told you that now we reached 80.7 million hectare, which is the 24.56% of the entire geographical area of our country. So now, because of the vigorous program of afforestation and by putting alternative source of energy, India wants to achieve reduction of carbon to permissible limits fixed by COP26 held at Glasgow this year. Now waste management around Delhi and NCR region, whereby agriculture crop residue burning has been addressed to, and this has reduced the intensity of pollution in NCR region. Again, green bonds are being issued by financial, non-financial institutions and public entities, where the proceeds are used to finance 100% green projects and assets. Again, exchange and dissemination of information to promote best practices in environmentally sustainable finance. So people are now being awakened as to the disastrous impact of global warming and pollution, and that's why now you see that government of India and different states are embarking upon cleaning different rivers like Ganga, Yamuna. So now a pollution free environment has become the primary goal of our all governments. Now health for all. Friends, as you know that government of India started national health policy in 2017, whereby it fixed its target of getting health for all. And that's why now what you see, the government, central government and state governments are all trying their level best to achieve health for all people. Now in our country, the health sector comprises ASHA workers, primary health center, community health center, district hospital and big hospitals like government medical college and hospitals. These are the important institutional mechanism by which the health facilities are provided to our citizens. Now the life expectancy at birth has increased to 10 years. Between 1992 to 2015, malnutrition still remains in one of the important problems for our country, because now it is still a risk factor at 14.6%. I mean, our total population, out of the total population, 14.6% people are suffering from malnutrition. Again, the contribution of air pollution to the disease remained in India at 9.8% in 2016. So this is the biggest challenge for us. And you see that how the polluted environment impact upon our lives. And that's how you see that the contribution of air pollution to the generation, the origin of our disease, is 9.8% in 2016. Now, neonatal disorder, nutritional deficiency, and infections are common causes of concern for all of us. Government launched Ayushman Bharat Yojana to provide comprehensive primary health sector facility, and Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana to 10.74 crore poor family. And you know that every family has at least 5 members. So by this Yojana, government wants to achieve the target of more than 55 crore people under the ambit of Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, whereby the treatment of 5 lakh per family is per family per year is free of cost, and this is a big achievement. But there is a chink in this policy, because so many non-BJP government did not accept this Yojana, citing different kinds of lacuna, and governments of West Bengal or Delhi started their own health programs for their state. So you see that this is the good program to alleviate or to fight out the health issues among the poor and downtrodden people, by which 10.74 crore families can get benefit up to 5 lakh rupees per year per family, free of cost treatment. Now, under Mission Indradhanush, you see that 3.39 crore children and 87.18 pregnant women in 600 districts have been vaccinated. Again, government vaccinated and against pandemic corona free of cost to all people above 12 years of age throughout India. And this is not a mean achievement. This is a big achievement. And that's why you see that in spite of the arrival of third or fourth variant, now India is oozing out confidence that now the entire population up to 12 years of age have been vaccinated against pandemic corona. Free drug services, free diagnostic services, free laboratory services, Jan Aushadhi Yojana, national dialysis programs have been launched to cater to the needs of the common man. Again, government focused 2/3 of its expenditure on primary health facilities. Doctor and population ratio in India is 1:1456 against the norm, WHO norm of 1:1000. Now, government of India and different states have embarked upon upgradation of district hospitals, इनटू मेडिकल कॉलेज इन द लास्ट 5 years 141 न्यू मेडिकल कॉलेज हैव बीन ओपेंड थ्रू आउट इंडिया. सीट्स ऑफ ग्रेजुएट एंड पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट्स हैव बीन इंक्रीज्ड. प्रधानमंत्री स्वास्थ्य सुरक्षा योजना कैटर्ड टू द नीड्स ऑफ द टर्सरी. हेल्थ केयर कैपेसिटी इन क्लिनिकल एंड मेडिकल एजुकेशन. द एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ मोर ऑल इंडिया इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मेडिकल साइंसेज इन डिफरेंट पार्ट ऑफ द कंट्री एम्स. नाउ गवर्नमेंट टुक ए स्पेशल इंटरेस्ट इन मिटिगेशन ऑफ कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज लाइक कालाजार, मलेरिया, जापानी इंसेफलाइटिस, कॉलरा. दीज कम्युनिकेबल डिजीजेस हैव बीन वेरी मच reduced. Their intensity have been very much reduced by the excellent efforts of central and state government in fighting out communicable diseases in our country. Now you see this chart that will show you that how the malaria, its occurrence has come down heavily from 2005 to now in 2015. Now this chart will show you that malaria cases and deaths in northeastern states. Friends, you know that northeastern states, I mean the seven sister states, are badly affected by malaria. And so government of India, its main focus was to mitigate or to reduce the incidences of malaria that caused large scale deaths. Now you see that this chart will show that in 2009 the deaths were 487 and now it has come down to 113 in 2012. So by this chart you can see that how the incidences of malaria in northeastern states are coming down. Now Kalajar, you see that this Kalajar, this communicable disease, is very much endemic in Bihar, particularly northern Bihar, Bengal, in Jharkhand area. So you see that by the sheer efforts of our government in 2005, the incidences of Kalajar were 32,803. Now you see that in this 2013, the incidence of Kalajar came down to 10,140 and the death is now 55. Now you see this, that in 2005 it was 137, now it has come down to 55. So both in terms of death and the incidences of occurrence of Kalajar, government has controlled its outbreak in the endemic areas of northern Bihar, West Bengal, Jharkhand state. Now, on account of dengue, it also causes large scale mortality among people. So you see that in 1996, what you see that the total incidences were 16,517. Now in 2012, it has gone to 50,222. But the case of fatality rate, what you see this fatality rate, now from 3.3%, it has come down to 0.5%. So there is a reduction in the fatality rate caused by dengue fever. Now friends, I come to the conclusion. What conclusion I derived from this lecture? Conference of Parties 26, COP 26 at Glasgow set a target of 1.5 degrees Celsius temperature reduction at the start of the pre-industrial phase or industrial evolution. Now India is doing a great job in reducing carbon emission and replacing it by renewable source of energy by way of solar energy, by the generation of hydroelectricity or wind energy. So the health of all is being implemented by government at all level, but private public participation is a must to cover all the people under health schemes. Friends, you know that the outbreak of pandemic corona completely exposed the health structure in India. Thousands and thousands of people affected by pandemic corona died, and they did not get ample facilities for treatment because of the lack of infrastructure, because of the lack of logistics like the supply of oxygen, because of the lack of doctors trained to treat pandemic corona. So now there is a need of making private public partnership to increase the level of health infrastructure in our country, since we are having 135 crore people, second largest population in the world. So there is still lack of medical infrastructure in our rural areas. Doctors do not go to rural areas for treatment. So we will have to address these problems. Further, we will have to increase the share of health sector in GDP by 6%, as it is prevalent in Western countries. Again, still we are very much dependent upon fossil fuels for the generation of energy. Our 80% energy is being produced by fossil fuels like coal, like oil, like gas. There is urgent need to reduce its share in the total generation of electricity. And government at different level, government of India and state governments, are doing their level best to increase the production of solar energy and other non-conventional source of energy to mitigate or reduce the emission of carbon. India has signed with different countries of the world for the generation of solar energy and transfer of its technology. So friends, now I am winding up my lecture. If you like my lecture, please share and subscribe. Please write your comments in the comment box. I will be very much indebted to you. Thank you very much.